picture when it comes to the fallout from the COVID pandemic, and it's already forcing a total rewrite of Australia's planning for the next decade as population growth comes to a screeching halt. Official figures have overseas migration going backwards, this for the first time because more people left Australia last year than arrived, and that's on top of our lowest birth rate on record.
Now, there were nearly 306,000 new babies in 2019 before COVID, but that was already down 3% on 2018. That's put Australia's population growth rate at the lowest level on record, close to nil, at 0.1%.
Social researcher Mark McCrindle joins us now to discuss the repercussions from these numbers. Mark, good morning to you. Let's look at that low birth rate. What do these numbers mean to demographers and population planners?
Well, that total fertility rate is the number of babies a woman could expect to have in her lifetime. So 1.6 means it's below replacement rates of 2, which is what a couple would need to replace themselves. It's even lower in Victoria at the moment at 1.5. And as you said, it's the lowest on record. Now, it was at replacement rates just a decade ago, so it's fallen rapidly since then. And the last time we saw this sort of slide was 20 years ago when the government brought in a baby bonus to stimulate some of those births. So we'll probably expect to see some of that policy intervention to boost the births right at the moment.
Right, so how things stand at the moment, just take us through some of the numbers that are being reset because of this. Does it now look like we won't reach that 30 million target by 2030?
Yeah, that's right. You know, with these unprecedented numbers, you know, lowest birth rate ever, plus the negative migration, which was 2/3 of our population growth, now with closed borders internationally, that's impaired not only for this year and obviously much of last year, but probably through 2022 as well. So we'll probably end up in about a decade or so at about 2 million people less than were the forecasts because of the migration negatives. So that means that we probably won't hit that 30 million mark until about the mid-2030s, rather than about 2030 as was forecast. So we're probably 4 or 5 years behind where we otherwise would have been. That's not altogether a bad thing because our population growth was probably running a bit too red hot, and there was, you know, some negatives of that, but it certainly had a bit of a boost to the economy when we were growing strongly.
Mark, these latest available figures are, of course, for 2019. Is there any early data yet about, you know, how we were tracking throughout the pandemic in 2020? I mean, people didn't have a lot to do.
Well, that's right. And so there was a thought that maybe we'll have a corona baby boom. But actually, we know from previous recessions and the world wars and other issues that when there's great uncertainty, people don't have a second or third child and people delay starting a family. And we could expect that to be the same this time around. You know, we've been in a recession, global uncertainty, you know, closed borders. We will expect the next numbers to show probably even a lower fertility rate. And also the migration is not going to come on strongly anytime soon as well. So these low population growth rate numbers are here to stay for the next couple of years.
So not everyone had the same idea as Matt, obviously. So what impact do these numbers have on the everyday lives of Australians?
Well, it does impact the economy. You know, that population growth does lead to economic growth. And, you know, we've seen that. Australia's been one of the fastest growing nations population-wise, and with that economically as well. But again, I think that a bit of a slowdown is going to be helpful. Yes, you know, it's going to mean slowdown in construction and infrastructure, which has been a big employer, but it'll probably just allow us to have a bit of catch-up in terms of apartment building and construction and a bit of that infrastructure planning. And I think in the medium term, a bit of a slowdown is helpful as well because it means the property prices won't get too out of hand for those first home buyers. But for groups like universities and that whole sector, you know, keep in mind overseas students was one of our biggest earnings sectors, and that's been massively impaired and does have an impact on sectors like the educators.
Massive impact. All right, Mark McCrindle, thank you. Always good to talk to you.